wants to dream about you and you living at your ashram, we could not dream. I mean, I could not dream. I mean, what is it? Am I living in optimum level?
See, dreams have no meaning except these two. Sometimes some light from the superconscious slips. Superconscious penetrates the unconscious. Then it has got some meaning. When you touch the glimpse of your higher being, when you get the glimpse of your higher being, in the dream, sometimes it penetrates the dream and expresses itself in your being. If it does not, there is nothing wrong. You don't have to worry about it. And if you want to dream, you will create dream and see. That is not real vision. One thing, the frequency of I is much less than the frequency of thoughts. The frequency of thoughts is more. That is why thoughts are just taking you away. You can't do anything. You are just guided. You can't do anything. The moment you try to stand on your legs, you try to understand, I'm not going to fall from the cliff. You wake up. You wake up.
So, sometimes you're sleeping and suddenly you remember something important or something that you should have done, and just in the middle of the sleep you just wake up and say, oh, I have to do that.
Then it means the waking body is entering into the subtle body. Even that is not good. Subtle body should be given its own place and space. Waking body should not interfere into the subtle body.
What's the reason?
Because you wanted so many things to be done in the waking body. Too much of desire to get attached to the waking body. It disturbs the subtle body. It comes into the space of subtle body. All the three, if they are given enough of your attention, you will never have problem and confusion between each other. When something is lacking, each one jumps on the other and tries to take his attention. Our space. Naturally, then you are in trouble.
Swami, some people say the early morning dreams come true.
Can I clarify something you said? You just said that sometimes the way people go into the subtle. So when I was working, oftentimes I'd bring my work everywhere with me and go to sleep. And whatever problem I was working on, I'd wake up in the morning and I'd figure out how I wanted to do it. I didn't know what the answer was at 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock the day before, but at 7 o'clock, I knew exactly what I had to do and how to sort through it. I kind of like that.
But according to me, it is not a healthy way of living. That time should be allotted for the dream and for the subconscious and unconscious process. It should not have any unnecessary interference from the physical layer. The more you try to utilize that two space, the more you will only feel sickness. You may like because you are having utility. It becomes a useful time. But surely, harnessing those energies unconsciously will not help. When you are having a dream, it should not be a continuation of your waking state. He says that I solve my problems there. It should not happen there. It should be some sort of a relief for your regular mental setup. It should be a vacation for you. It should not be a continuous work. It should be a weekend for you. It should not be a day, weekday for you. That's more healthy. Try to just whenever you feel satisfied because you did something in the dream and it helped you, try to hate that. Tell your mind, no, take rest at that time. You don't have to work. Just have a good vacation. Then automatically you will see the attitude will change. If you encourage, the same thing will continue. There's every chance you will be just possessed by the job which you do, which is not good actually. You need some vacation. You need something to change. and the mechanism automatically, that there is a natural mechanism inside you which wants to give you a change in the rest. So you must have that change and rest, otherwise there is a chance of becoming mad. Sorry, but it is the truth. Because if you are possessed by a single idea, there is a chance of becoming mad. And if you are possessed by a higher ideal, there is a chance of becoming enlightened. But at least these ordinary ideas will not give you enlightenment. So,
are there any beings around us with fewer than three bodies? Are there any beings with no physical body?
Yes. With no physical body, there are beings who stay just with these two bodies. Let me explain. If a person is supposed to live 100 years and he commits suicide or he is killed in 40 years itself, other 60 years he has to live without physical body, with just subtle body and causal body. One important thing you have to understand, they cannot harm you. Please be very clear, they cannot harm you. It is your fear towards them makes you feel they may harm you. They cannot harm you. Because they are loyal. They have 66 acres only. You have 100 acres. You understand? You are much bigger person than them. See, you have all the three body. Physical, mental and causal. They have only two body. So naturally, they are weaker than you. How can they disturb you? But your idea about them is given by horror movies. Please be very clear, no horror movie is true. Spirits cannot disturb you. Except your faith in them, no other disturbance can happen to you by spirits. The power of negativity is only one thing, your faith on them, that's all. Yes, they can help you. They can communicate with you. They can relate with you, but they can never harm you. Because you are a superior being. And actually they are afraid of you. And I tell you from my experience, only living people disturb us, never dead people. Living people only disturb us, never dead people. Dead people never disturb us. So, they can never harm you. They can never disturb you. Yes.
I know you're talking about dreams in the sleep state, but a lot of times children will be looking out the window and they call it daydreaming.
Yes.
And you can snap your fingers or something and they jump back. Is there anything related to that?
If the depth of the night dreaming is too much, means there will naturally height of the daydreaming. The daydreaming and the night dreaming is very closely related. If the daydreaming is too much, then you will have deep night dream. If you dream less, then the day also, there will be less dream. Children need more dreams to cope up with reality. Mainly, their visualization is disturbed by this education. By the, when you start getting ready in the line of logic or the verbalization, their visualization gets destroyed. So they need some support to hold on. They start dreaming. They start dreaming.
Swamiji, back to my thing about falling off the cliff. Why is it, I don't understand, why is it that I never actually fall? Or the harm never
by the time you let the fear comes to the peak, man, you become aware of it. The awareness comes up. Then you are out. And here also, in the life also, if you come to the present moment, any bad incident which is supposed to happen in your life can be stopped and can be turned. Same thing what you see in the dream can happen here. One important insight which you need to understand, again the same tribal people with whom I lived, they have a habit. There is a center of the village, there is a temple. If you hurt somebody, if you disturb somebody in your dreams, next day morning, you come to the temple, call that person and you ask him to forgive you. You offer some flowers and fruits to him, some gift to you, to him, and ask him to forgive you. Strange habit. I asked him, what is this? You hurt him only in the dream. Why are you asking him to forgive in the daytime? You will be surprised. He gave a statement, shocking statement. Only an enlightened man can give. He said, what are you talking? Dreams are made of the same stuff in which world is made. World is made of same stuff in which dreams are made. Understand, it is very difficult for us to understand. But truth. Let me tell you a small story. One Zen master, early morning he woke up from his bed, started weeping like anything. He started shouting, crying. All disciples ran to him. Why are you weeping? Why are you weeping? What happened to you? You are an enlightened person. You cannot cry. Poor fellows, they can't even cry. Just because they are enlightened. You cannot cry. People have got weird ideas about enlightenment. Anyhow. You cannot cry. What happened? He said, oh, yesterday night I dreamt I became butterfly. He said, what is there? After all, there's nothing wrong. It's a dream. Over. Now you are all right. Now you are here. Why should you bother about it? Forget about it. Enjoy this moment. Forget. Don't bother. Why should you bother about it? It's a dream. Then the master says, the problem is, I do not know whether I dreamt I became butterfly or that butterfly is dreaming now it has become master. I don't have clarity. That is why I am weeping. Understand, actually there is no guarantee you are sitting and listening to my discourse. There is no guarantee you are attending my discourse. It can be dream. Don't say, I can pinch and see. Even in the dreams you can pinch and see. What is the guarantee? That what is happening now is a waking, not a dream. Tell me.
Your dream.
Color. When you dream, actually you dream, you see multicolor only. Only when you wake up, you don't remember. The dream, you remember multicolor only.
So this could be a vision.
If you remember in multicolor only, then it is vision. Analyze this idea. I give a hypothesis now. Dreams are made of same stuff in which world is made. And the world is made of the same stuff in which dreams are made. Any contradiction if you have, come up. Let us analyze. Yes.
Samaji, dream is individual. 65 people sitting, having the same dream.
Understand. In the dream, you think that it is individual? Dream also you can see 10 people. What 65? 70 you can see.
No, but different to different people though. Not the same dream for everybody.
See, one thing. You say now, it is not same dream. When you see in the dream, different people. Different people actually act different parts. Am I right?
Right.
Different people actually act different parts. Then what do you say about it?
And you don't know how different people here are perceiving this dream.
Yes.
You only know how you are.
Yes.
But in this, even if this was a dream, we cannot be in control because with the other dream we only have when we go to sleep.
One thing.
But that one ejects us anytime.
One thing. You mean to say here you have control and there you don't have control.
Right, because it'll abort the dream anytime.
One thing, in that dream also don't think you don't have control. When you come out, you don't have control. When you are in it, you have control. Now, if you become enlightened, then you don't have control on this. In that, the time within a very short limit you come out, you are thrown out. So you say it's a dream. Here, in after 10 janma, 12 janma, you are thrown out. You became enlightened. Then you say it's a dream. So only the time gap is little less or more. And again, one more thing. Let me give one more argument and give the answer also before that let me answer the question.
If everybody else is
also seeing the same blue, all, even if it is that, it can be dream. Because in the dream, yes, the whomsoever you are seeing, you see in the dream, you see a tiger and run. Your friend also will see a tiger and run with you. It's not that you cannot say it's a waking state. In the dream, you and your friend, both of you see a tiger. Both of you run. Am I right? Yes.
That being said, so my next doubt is whether we're all looking at the same thing the same way, and if so, why are we looking at it the same way? How is it that we are able to perceive things the same way? Should it be different?
Say that again. How we all
there is no
the
need it should be different.
I mean, how is it that, let's just say this is not reality. Let's put the question mark that this is a dream, or that is a dream, or both are dreams. That being said, why is it that we all see a circle as a circle, or blue color as blue?
You see, because your thought is a blue.
And everybody else has thought the same thing?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
One thing, if you see this, in my mind, the word manjal only raises, not the yellow.
Uh-huh.
Then it gets translated. In your mind, yellow raises. In my mind, only Tamil word raises. So I can say it is manjal, Tamil word for yellow. And you can say it is yellow. But when we speak in the same language, we use the same word. That's all. What we see, what we think, can be different. But because we speak in the same language, we understand the same thing. And that I may tell that it's a circle. You may have your own word, but it's a circle is a circle. Because both are taught it is a circle. We think it is a circle.
So if you were taught something else, or
naturally I will see it as a different. I'll have a different name.
So if there was a baby born that was completely in isolation and that baby was taught something completely different.
Surely it will have different words and different ideas.
Words.
This is, I'm just assuming there's no words, because words again, it complicates the idea that I'm trying to understand. Just mere perception. What is the gap that you and me and everybody else is looking at it the same way? I mean, why is it not completely different? Of course, in a subtle way, there is a complete different perception. Whether the perception is different or same, the argument, this is dream, stands. That is what I want to prove. Don't bother about whether we are seeing differently or the same way. That let us not bother about it. Let us bother about this idea, analyze this.